back to Accounting's Number One Fan. Please pardon the mess. I have been looking up things on WebMD all morning trying to diagnose the Patient Protection and Affordable Care Act, trying to figure out if it is going to stay or be repealed. I have been putting in all the symptoms and looking at all the possible conditions, and I have been able to determine that the Pepeka is suffering from a sprained ankle. That can't be right. Oh well, I'll have the symptoms later. Perhaps by then they'll be able to have a section where you can mark your political affiliation. Anyway, today we're going to play a game called What If, where we look into both sides of a recent healthcare reform story, the King versus Burwell case, and discuss what might happen when the ruling is passed down. Some of you might be thinking, who's King? Who's Burwell? Why are they fighting? Here's your 20-second wrap-up. King is David King, the lead plaintiff representing the petitioners against the Patient Protection and Affordable Care Act. These petitioners are arguing that the ACA only provides low-income subsidies for state-run exchanges, while the IRS has been providing subsidies on state-run exchanges and federal exchanges. Burwell is Sylvia Matthews Burwell, United States Secretary of Health and Human Services, representing the government. All in all, this is a case of semantics. What was meant by established by the state in the original Affordable Care Act? The plaintiff is looking for it to be defined as a letter of the law, meaning that only state-run exchanges can offer low-income subsidies, while the defendant is looking for it to be defined as the intent of the law, meaning that state-run exchanges, in addition to the federal marketplace, can offer low-income subsidies, making health insurance affordable. And now it's time to play What If. Ron Present, partner and healthcare group industry leader at Brown Smith Wallace, is going to help us lay out the possible scenarios that might take place when the verdict is released this summer and determine what steps employers should take. So the first what if I'd like to address is, what if the Supreme Court defines established by the state as letter of the law?
I think what will happen is the whole healthcare reform act related to the provision of insurance will begin to unravel. If it begins to unravel, one of the decisions or one of the determinations will have to be what actions Congress will take. Will they go in and modify, or will this be the opportunity for the more conservatives in Congress to repeal the entire act?
And what if they are faced with that decision?
I personally don't think that they would repeal, because there's now approximately 12 million people that now have insurance that didn't have insurance before or potentially underinsured. And I don't think any legislator who's coming up for election or potential election is going to want to tell 12 million people that they no longer have insurance.
Okay, so that's the what if the Supreme Court defines it as letter of the law. Now, what if the Supreme Court defines it as intent of the law?
If they say the intent of the law, then what will happen is that there will be literally no change to the legislation.
What should employers do to plan for these potential outcomes?
Continue to look at their benefit plans strategically. So regardless of the decision of the Supreme Court, their strategy should be flexible enough to be able to incorporate those changes. Number two, they need to ensure that their current plan is meeting the current regulations. Number three, they need to be considering the new forms and new reporting requirements that are taking place this year that will be required to be reported in 2016.
Fantastic. Well, Ron, thank you again for playing What If. So while we don't know when the ruling will be passed, we do know a decision can be expected late June or early July. If you have any questions about healthcare reform until then, you should talk to your advisor, or you can check out bswllc.com and we can help you find a suitable advisor. And keep an eye out for our next video, which will come out once the decision is made. Until then, I guess I'll just hang out here. Did someone say Macbeth?